The Boko Haram insurgency was well into its fifth year, a murderous campaign of bombings and shootings that had killed thousands. Yet it was the kidnapping of these girls that propelled Boko Haram onto the world stage. Almost 300 youngsters snatched from their school, many then paraded on camera by a man purporting to be Boko Haram's leader, Abubakar Shekau. Chibok also threw the spotlight onto Nigeria's security forces and their struggle to meet the Boko Haram threat. For days after the kidnapping, officials gave out conflicting stories about what happened, how many had been taken, how many escaped, and even now has not given a comprehensive list of the missing girls. Some Nigerians also have criticized the response of the presidency. The security forces have long claimed to know where the girls are, but fear they'll be killed should troops move in. President Goodluck Jonathan repeatedly has promised to what it takes to secure the girls' release.
Bring back our girls.
Behind him, Jonathan has secured an unprecedented international partnership. Help from countries including China, America, and other African nations.
And the government of China promised to assist us, and I believe that assistance will come almost immediately. The government of the United States of America, the United Kingdom, and France have also spoken with me and have expressed their commitment to help us resolve this crisis in Nigeria.
The girls' fate also became an international cause. 6 months on though, the Chibok schoolgirls remain in captivity. Many fear their ordeal could last yet longer. Kofa Mrenje, CCTV, Nairobi, Kenya.